Okay, so last session we have discussed like before class how to work with like before class, right? So I've shown you this one also. Okay, I have sent you this execution flow of that. So here, next topic is how to create TestNG XML file automatically. So how to create this XML file? So you can create as a project level also, or you can create as a package level also. Okay. If you will create as a project level, then you will get all the methods which is available in your project. But I want to create as a package level. So here we will go and just we can go for TestNG and convert TestNG. So by default, XML file name is testng.xml. So I'm not changing the name here. So this is your, testng.xml file. Okay. So here, this is all our, the by default tags are there. So we having the suite tag, okay. Just we can understand. Suite means like one application is there, banking application. Inside this banking application, we having the multiple module of that application, like we having the loan department. So here the one suite I will create for loan department. So first, module is your loan department. Inside this module, we have a some modules, like in the loan department, we have a car loan, we have education loan, home loan. So that will define as a test level. Okay. And this is your class tag, right? This is your class. Here we are getting the class name. So classes, inside this classes, how many classes are there? Two classes. So here, how to keep the name for that com.testng. This is your package name. You can see this is our package name com.testng.classname. So we have a two class here. So here you can define how many classes are there. And this is your closing. Here it is closing and all. So this is how we have a default feature for XML file. How to execute test cases through XML. We can execute, just right click and run as. You can just execute TestNG suite. You can see now we can execute our test case by using the XML, TestNG.xml. So how to create the XML, TestNG XML file, how to execute, test case from TestNG.xml file. And another question is, what is the default name of XML file? TestNG.xml. Okay. So we have a five test cases. Inside this, if we will go here and all the test cases is executed, right? So this error is coming for my some configuration issue will be there in my system. So you can see all the test cases are passed in this. We having the three test cases. Here we have three test cases, and here we have a two test cases. Last time we have discussed, right? So this all the test cases will pass, and you will get here default report also. If you will refresh this, and if you will go here, and you will get the default report also, HTML report. If you will open this, and you will get this report also, how many test cases. So we have a five test cases here. You can see this, all these five test cases, and all are passed because you are getting the green tag, and this is like the test case name here. Okay, so this is the default report you will get it. So here, how to generate XML file, select all the package. If you want to create a XML as a package level, or right click and select TestNG and click on convert into the TestNG. Then click on finish. So these are the steps you will get it. And finally, I want to show you one more thing here. Like if you will go in the TestNG, we have a this also, so you have to go here in the source section, okay? Then you will get this XML file, okay? So that's why, and here after creating the file, this is the how looks like the XML file. So same thing I have written here, okay? So collection of multiple test cases is called test suite. Execute multiple test cases through testengine.xml file is called batch execution. In order to achieve batch execution, all the test cases should be implemented using the testng classes and testng annotation. So testng batch execution can be done by using the XML file, and XML file always start from suite, and test class XML tag is like that. One testng suite can have a multiple test runner. In order to execute n number of testng class, specify the testng class name along with package name in class XML tag. Testng always start from @test, right? Testng always execute @test method based on their alphabetical order. In order to execute test case in the specific order, either we can use the priority concept or we can use the depends upon. So 0 is the topmost priority and minus is can have allowed, you know. So let me show you. Here we have some dependency between the test cases, right? So how to provide the dependency or prioritize the test cases? Prioritize PRIO. Just I'm writing, you can take any class name. So just I'm writing few test cases, test public void TC 01, and here so import this, and let me display some dummy message here, and this is your TC01. So I'm using some dummy test cases, okay? So you guys can use, okay, so these are the test cases. So here we have to demo 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And here we have attribute name priority and return type is integer. So here I will give accordingly, here I will give the 4, and here I will give, just I'll copy paste here. Here I will give 2. Okay, so I'm giving 2 here. This third one I'm giving I have done mistake. Okay, this is the fourth, like I am giving here 3, and here I will give 1. Okay, I will give 1, and here 3 is pending, right? So here I will give the 3 1. So whatever the order you have given, the you have prioritized here, in that order only this test case will execute. So I have, okay, one more is pending, so I will come on that. Okay, leave this, and here I will write, let me show you, minus or 0. Okay, you can see you have will execute this, and you can see in which order it will execute. So test case number 4 executed first. Sorry, test case number 5, okay, because 0 is the highest priority. Okay, and then it will executed test case number 3. So 3 you have given first one, right? So like that you can give. So if you will add, I will add one more test case. Okay, so I will add here 6 and and here I will write 6. This is 6 only. Sorry guys. 0, 6. Okay. And now I will write minus 1. So minus is your highest PFT. Okay. So see, these are all the things when you will execute your test cases.